Good morning, students. Today, in last lecture, I have discussed how can you express 0.6 bar, 0.67 or 0.001 bar in the form of P upon Q. The next question is, how can you express this 0.235, this one, 0.235, this bar is only on 35. So how can you express this number in the form of P upon Q? You listen very carefully. First of all, you suppose that xg equal to 0.235 bar. You listen very carefully. First of all, you see it in between bar and point, how many digits are here? Here only one digit is here, 2. So first of all, you multiply this equation, this first equation, by 10. If in between like this 0.2347 bar, so first of all you multiply this number by 100, because here 2 digits are there. It is clear to you? If one digit is in between point and this bar, you multiply both sides by 10. If 2 digits are here in between point and between the bar, you multiply both sides by 100. If 3 digits are here like this, 0.02347 bar, you multiply both sides by 1000. It is clear to you? So multiply both sides by 10. 10 into x, 10x, 10 into 0.235 bar. Then if you multiply this number by 10, then point will be shift here, 0.235 bar. This equation number 2. It's clear to you? And then here 2 digits are repeating. As in our previous question, I have told you, here 2 digits are repeating. You multiply both sides by 100. If one digit is repeating, multiply by 10. If 2 digits are repeating, multiply both sides by 100. If 3 digits are repeating, multiply both sides by 1000. So here multiply both sides by 100. You will get 100 into 10x equal to 100 into 2.35 bar. No need to write here 0, because there is no value of 0 here. And this is, you multiply 1000x equal to, if you multiply this number by 1000, you see very attentively here, 2.35 bar means 35 is repeating here. So multiply both sides by 100. 235.3535. So on this you can write like this. Clear? Because 3535 is repeating, you can write like this in bar form. And then 235.35 bar, this equation number 3. Subtract equation number 2 from equation 3. 1000x equal to 235.35 bar, or 10xg equal to 2.35 bar, 1000
minus 10, 9, 9, 0, x equal to, you subtract 235, this minus 2, that will be equal to 233. Point is here, if you subtract this one by this, you will get 0. So x equal to 233 upon 990, and in the you can write here 0.235 bar equal to 233 upon 990. In other word, you can say that here, if you divide this 233 by 990, you will get 0.235 bar. Any doubt? So now I will take your next exercise. Yes. Now, exercise 1.3. This question number 4. This question number 4 expresses 0.9999 up to so on in the form of P upon Q. Are you surprised by your answer? With your teacher and classmate, discuss why the answer makes sense. You listen carefully. Let x is equal to 0.99999 up to so on. This you can write like this. Because 9 is repeating here, you can write 0.9 bar. And similarly, as I have discussed 0.6 bar, how can you express in the form of P upon Q? You solve like this. This equation number first, multiply both sides by, multiply both side by 10. 10 into x, 10x. 10 into 0.9 bar. 10x is equal to 9.9 bar. Clear? As I have told you, 0.999, if you multiply both sides this by 10, you will get 0.999 up to so on. This you can write 9.9 bar, because 9 is repeating here. This equation number second, subtract equation first from equation second. 10x is equal to 9.9 bar, x is equal to 0.9 bar, then 9x equal to 9.0, and x is equal to 9 upon 9 equal to 1, or 0.9999 up to so on, that will be equal to 1. Because 0.999 up to so on, it is very 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 near to 1. So that will be equal to 1. Next question. Then question number 5, what can be the maximum number of digit be repeated the block of digit in the decimal of 1 upon 17? perform the division by check your answer. Students, if you divide this 1 by 17, it will be non-terminating but repeating. But when you divide this 1 by 17, you will surprise that the remainder will repeat, I think, after 16 digit, it will repeat. So, my students, from the very beginning, on the top of the page, you will divide and you go on doing, and then again will be 1 after, I think, 16 digits. So, this you can do yourself. Then next one is, look at the several example of ratio number P upon Q, where P and Q are integers with no common factor other than 1 having terminating decimal representation. Can you guess what property Q must satisfy? This question number 6 is, when you see some examples P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and P and Q are coprime. Coprime means two numbers are said to be coprime if they have no common factor except 1. For example, 2, 3. They are coprime. They are having no common factor except 1. Can you say that here 6 and this 24, they are coprime? No, they are not coprime, because you divide this 6, 1 is 6, 6, 4 is 24. 6 is the common factor of 6 and 24. So 6, 1 is 6, 6, 4 is 24. 1 and 4, they are coprime. So when you divide this question, when you solve question number 1, then what you have been observed, then P upon, when P and Q are integers and P and Q are coprime, then what property of Q will satisfy if number is terminating? Then I will tell you, if factor of Q having powers of 2 or 5 or both. Clear? For example, 17 upon 8. This you can write 2 to the power 3. It is a terminating decimal, because here factor of denominator, factor of Q, having in the form of 2 to the power n. 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Like this. Second example, 13 upon 25. Yes, it is also terminating decimal, because factor of denominator having power of 5. And this also 1 upon 2 to the power 3, 5 to the power 2. It is also terminating decimal, because here factor of denominator having power of 2 and 3 both. Can you say that here 13 upon 2 to the power 3, 5 to the power 4 into 3, it is a terminating decimal? No, because here it is a prime number, and here factor of denominator having power of 2 and 5 except this, that is 3. Here the factor of denominator having a number, that is 3. Clear? Because if It is clear here is the factor of q means denominator having power of 2 or 5 or both. It is terminating because here except power of 2 and 5, that is 3 is here. So it is non-terminating but repeating. It is clear to you? And then next one is question number 7. Write 3 number whose decimal expansion are non-terminating and non-recurring means repeating. Or you can say these numbers are called irrational number. So how can you give the example of non-terminating and non-repeating, students? 0.12122122, like this. This number, it is not terminating because here dash 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 they are going on, and non-repeating also, no block of digit is repeating here. 1 2 1 double 2 1 triple 2 up to so on. Similarly, next examples you can write 0.13 1 double 3 1 triple 3, like this. You can write other also 0.14 1 double 4 1 triple 4 up to so on, and you can write so many rational, irrational number whose decimal expansion is non-terminating and non-repeating. Now, and I have told you root 2, root 3 and pi are irrational number. If you take the square root of 2 and 3, you will get decimal of these two number is non-terminating and non-repeating. Next question is, find 3 different irrational number between 5 by 7 and 9 upon 11. How can you find 3 irrational number between this and this? See very attentively. First of all, 5 divided by 7. You will take point here, then bring down 0, 7, 7 ja, 49, subtract 1 is here, then 0, 7, 1 ja, 7, 3, then 7, 4 ja, 28. Then you can write in decimal form 0.14714. Clear? And then 9 divided by 11. 0.0 11 8 is 88 2 0 11 1 is 11 9 11 8 is 88. So it is, because 2 is repeating here, non-terminating but repeating. Now you can write this one like this. 0 point decimal of this is 818. Then you, how can you write the 3 irrational number between 0.174 and 0.818 between this two? 0.71 and 0.81. First number is 0.72, next number is 0.73, 0.74 up to 0.80. You can write the first number is this, second number and third number. The question is, how can you make it non-terminating and non-repeating? Because irrational number is the decimal representation of irrational number are non-terminating and non-recurring, means repeating. So you can make like this: 72, 722, 722, up to so on, 73, 733, 733, up to so on, then 744, 744, up to so on. So these are the three irrational number whose lies between 5/7 and 9/11. First of all, you convert into decimal form, and what is the number between 0.7 and 0.8? No, because here you will take two digit after decimal, and you will get the 0. Between 0.71 and between 0.18. 0.71, 0.72, 0.73, 0.74, up to 0.80. This clear? Next question is, question number 9. Classify the following number as rational and irrational. First, root 23. Root 23, because you cannot take the square root of exact square root of perfect square of this, so it is an irrational number. Root 25 equal to 5, it is irrational number. Then second, root 225. What is the square root of 225? 15. 15 is a rational number. Third, .3796. It is a terminating decimal. A terminating decimal is a rational number. Clear? And then fourth is 7.478478, up to so on. This you can write 7.478 bar. This number is called non-terminating and non-repeating. So this number is also called rational number. Definition of rational number is, as I had told earlier in when I discussed rational number, then the decimal representation of rational number either terminating or non-terminating repeating, they are called rational number. Then last one is 1.10, 100, 1000, 14 times 0, 1 up to so on. This number is non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. So it is called irrational number. It is clear? And then I will start your next exercise. 1.5. Let us start. 1.5. Classify the following number as rational and irrational. First, question number 1. First, 2 minus root 5. This rational minus irrational always irrational. You see very attentively. Clear? So it is an irrational number.
irrational number.
If you subtract irrational from rational, you find always an irrational number. Second,
3 plus root 23 minus root 23. 3 plus root 23 minus root 23, you cancel out 3. 3 is a rational number. Clear? Third one
is 2 root 7 upon 7 root 7. Root 7 cancel by root 7, you will get 2 upon 7. And 2 upon 7 in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0, so it is a rational number. Then fourth,
1 upon root 2, rational divided by irrational, always irrational. Clear? So it is an irrational number. Fifth, 2 pi. You know very well, 2 is a rational number and pi is an irrational number. So, rational into irrational. The multiplication of rational and irrational always irrational. So, this is an irrational number.
Now see, question number 2. In question number 2, simplify the following expression. First, 3 plus root 3 into 2 plus root 2. How can you simplify it? You see very attentively. Here no identity are using. So this 3 multiplied by first 2. 3 into 2. Then plus into plus plus 3 multiplied by this 3 root 2. Clear? And here root 3 multiplied by 2 plus into plus plus 2 root 3, then plus into plus plus root 3 into root 2. Clear? Then 3 to ja 6, 3 root 2, 2 root 3, multiplication of root 3 into root 2. As I have told you, root AB equal to root A into B. I have discussed in identities when I had discussed identities. Then, if root A into root B here, so you multiply this root A into B, means root 3 into 2. 6 plus 3 root 2. Plus 2 root 3 plus root 6 is the answer. Clear? And then second part,
3 plus root 3, 3 minus root 3.
You see what identity is using here. You identify first. You see very attentively, when I had discussed A minus root B, A plus root B into A minus root B, this will be equal to A plus B into A minus B equal to A square minus B square. If you multiply A minus B into A plus B, you will get A square minus B square. this a square, root of a square and root b square means, root b into root b, root b into b, b square. This cancel out here, b. So you apply this identity here. In place of a, 3 here, 3 square, minus in place of b, root 3 here, whole square, 3 square, 9, root 3 square, 3, that will be equal to 6. Thank you. Next question I will discuss in next video lecture.